Hello, very good morning and welcome to Adhavan Newspaper Highlights. Today, Wednesday, 26th of April 2017. This is Edward with the highlights of today's English newspapers. As usual, we have three leading daily newspapers for the highlights. Daily Mirror, Daily News and Salon Today. Firstly, let's have a look on the Daily Mirror. The main headline highlights. President proposes to Cabinet. Sarat Fonseca-led committee to deal with emergencies. President Maithripala Sirisena is reported to have proposed the setting up of a special subcommittee headed by Minister Sarath Fonseca to make recommendations on how best to deal with emergency situations such as any disruption to the power supply, to port activities or to fuel distribution. The idea was mooted against the backdrop of the disruption caused to fuel distribution by petroleum workers launching trade union action against the move to lease the Trincomalee oil tank farm to Lanka India Oil Company. Constitutional reforms. Steering committee to present interim report soon. Prime Minister says it will be debated in Parliament. He defended the newly set up oversight committees. The Constitutional Assembly Steering Committee is expected to submit its interim report shortly and it will be taken up for debate soon after, Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe said yesterday. Concerns over missing persons. TPC to launch Hartal in North East. The Tamil People's Council, led by Northern Province Chief Minister C.V. Vigneswaran, warned they would stage a Hartal in the northern and eastern provinces to compel the government to resolve the concerns raised by the relatives of those gone missing during the armed conflict. Meethutamulla tragedy. Title deeds to another 65 victims. An amount of 392 million rupees has been allocated for the provisions of houses. Secondly, let's move to Daily News. The main headline highlights. Trincomalee oil tank farm. Cabinet note for MOU with India. No specific agreement or venture discussed. Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe arrived in India having secured cabinet approval to enter into a memorandum of understanding with the Indian government over the oil tank farm in Trincomalee. It is only a political decision. No specific agreement or venture was discussed, Petroleum and Petroleum Resources Minister Chandima Veerakodi told the Daily News. PFC to ensure transparent financial system. The establishment of the Public Finance Committee will provide the mechanism for a more vibrant and transparent financial system in the country in the future, Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe said yesterday. He also said the introduction of new system of sectoral oversight committees will further strengthen Parliament. Finally, let's move to Salon Today. The main headline highlights. Maitri sacks Janaka, Anura and Lohan. President Maithripala Sirisena's drive to appoint new electoral organisers, replacing those with Rajapaksa loyalties, yesterday led to the sacking of former Minister Janaka Bandara Tennakon, MP Lohan Ratwatha and MP Anura Vidhanagama. Maitri tells Ranil, keep your promise while in India. President Maithripala Sirisena is said to have told Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe not to break the promise he gave the Ceylon Petroleum Corporation trade unions when he visits India. The President has informed the Prime Minister of this at the cabinet meeting held yesterday. Army managed farms and preschools. Ex-LTTE cadres protest NPC takeover. Several hundred rehabilitated ex-LTTE cadres, both men and women presently serving in the Civil Security Department, staged a demonstration yesterday against the handing over of army-managed agricultural farms and preschools to the Northern Provincial Council. With that, let's come to an end of today's paper highlights. We will come with more news tomorrow morning. Thanks for listening to Adhavan News Paper Highlights.